Sai Ram. With pranams at the lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan, dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to this morning Sunday satsang. So glad to have all of you here. Lest I forget, I want to make an announcement to our friends. Somehow a thought came into my mind, for good or bad I do not know. The time has to decide. Years have been passing by unnoticed. Lifespan is also getting shortened day by day. Years have passed. When I just relax and question myself, what is it that I gained? What is it I got? Is it merely some stories? Is it merely a couple of experiences? Where do I stand in the spiritual ladder? In the spiritual journey, where am I? Sometimes this feeling frustrates me, depresses me. Though people say, Anil Kumar, you are so close to Swami, you have done that, you have done that. Though I have read about 10, 25 books to my credit, about 500 DVDs there, and a regular website, saiwisdom.com. Quite a number of blessings to talk to different youth groups from all over India and abroad, and devotees. Yet I feel some lacuna, some emptiness. I do not know why. It's not anything to do with the physical emptiness. If it is physically empty, I can eat some more idlis and be happy with it. If it is just psychological emptiness, I can read some more books, think some more until I turn mad. It is not psychological emptiness. It is not intellectual emptiness either. Why? Because I can go on arguing with people, win an argument, and build up stories in support of my stand, cook up so many things. Therefore, as I relax and think of the bygone years, 42 years of life with Swami, 20 years in the organization, 22 years right under his nose, 42 years. I often question myself, where am I? In which direction my life going? How far am I near the goal? What is the goal actually? What was the past and what is the present? Going bhajan, attending bhajans, okay. Eating prasadam distributed every day, okay. Telling stories, listening to stories, okay. Talking, because nothing else to do. Is that all? Still I feel something wanting, something demanding, something challenging, something to face, something to realize. I'm writing a couple of articles in Telugu Sanatana Sarathi, explaining my 40 years of journey with God. And those articles are in Telugu, Sanatana Sarathi. But I know how you will react when I say that. Why only Telugu? I am not a linguistic chauvinist. Certainly not. I am not a linguistic leper. I will never be. I can only say one thing. These articles published in Telugu Sanatana Sarathi, journey with God for the last 40 years or so. Memories and memoirs are being written in Telugu Sanatana Sarathi. So far, 4 articles have been published. As per their norms, more than 4 pages cannot be published by written by any author. So under that limitation, I think it will go, the material I have given them is enough till August or September. Because when I start writing, it won't end. When any flash comes, I start writing. What is my idea in writing these articles? Is it any publicity? I don't think that there is any other publicity that I need at this stage. If at all, the destiny is not going to take me away, only bad name I should try for it. The good name I have as of today. I don't have to seek anybody's favor or fear anyone. So I thought this way. One, what are the experiences, miracles I have witnessed to myself? So far I have been speaking of the experience of others. About me? Have I not seen anything on my own? Am I only a tape recorder? Or a DVD? Or a news reporter? I am not, my friends. God has given me many opportunities to be witness of certain experiences, miracles happening. I thought they should be recorded. Number 2, miracle is not for a miracle. Experience is not for an experience. Experience or a miracle, whatever you call, has got a purpose behind it, has got a message to be conveyed. It is not just to go on describing, bragging about it, publicizing about it, making use it as an apology for propaganda, bloating in ego. That's not that, my friends. Every experience, every miracle has a message behind it. Swami's message. I thought that underlying message also has to be conveyed. That's my second objective. And the third objective is, people think so-and-so is a great devotee, so-and-so is a great devotee. And there are also books published on eminent devotees, prominent devotees, dominant devotees. I don't understand. A devotee is a devotee. What? Who is eminent? Who is prominent? Who is dominant? I wonder how you call, you give the titles on your own. I can't say I'm eminent devotee. Nonsense. The fact I say I'm eminent, it means not at all. Or VIP devotees. Horrible terminology. Very difficult to listen to them also. And swallow. I know many, many people, my friends, many, many, thousands of them. Because across the globe for the last 40 years, it's natural we'll come to know. Why me alone? Everybody in the village also know them. Because we see people coming and going. It's not anything special to Anil Kumar. As I see many, many people come and go, please kindly believe me, when I say the devotees who sit at the back are 100% devotees. Please take it from me. 100%. Why? They never say that we didn't get Pada Namaskar. They never say, I did not get a chain. I did not get a ring. I had no chance to give a letter. I had no chance to give a flower. Nothing. The backward benches are forward in Kulwanthal, I can tell you. They are forward. I know my friend sitting there. I purposefully go there to get charged. Because I move closer and closer to the front, I get discharged. Now, in fact, I'm telling you. So I go and talk. So those, yes, silent devotees who have nothing to ask for. Now, do you want an interview? He cannot ask for an interview sitting in the 100th row. So no desire for an interview. Do you want to give a letter? How can I? He cannot jump all the 100 lines like Hanuman. Impossible. You want to sit close to him? Impossible. You are far away. But still, they hold on to their feet. That is the sign of an eminent, prominent, dominant, glaring, conspicuous, apparent, great, noble, ideal devotee. To that extent only my vocabulary permits. Though I would like to say even more. And the second thing is also this. They have only love to share, eagerness to hear others, inquisitiveness to learn, acquire. Therefore, my friends, they have been forgotten. They have not been taken note of. My experience is nothing for you, whereas governor's experience is important. I don't know. Governor experience is important as governor, not as a devotee. Governor and me are same as devotees. Don't you think so? In Sai Darbar, all are same. No governor, no president. Therefore, my friends, over these 40 years, I met so many devotees, villagers, illiterate, you may say rustic. They are better than lipstick. These people who are not known, who don't care to be known either, who have no desire, nothing, working for the organization, working for Sai movement, silently. We have two rivers flowing in Andhra Pradesh. There are many, two are very well known to people. One Krishna, other Godavari. As Krishna river flows, you hear the sound. As Godavari flows, you do not know that it is flowing. Such Godavari devotion is there among those people. Silently, calm, serene, dignified, dignified, steady, spiritual, constant, integrated, meditative, contemplative, hearts, emotions. I wanted to mention those names of the devotees who are exemplary, who are ideals. It is one reason why I am writing Memories and Memoirs. The another thing is also this. As in the field of politics, there are people who are new in the organization who think that today, you know what we are doing in our Sai Center? You know what is happening in our district? Sir, please keep quiet. Think of the foundation. First know your father, grandfather, great-grandfather. Then speak of yourself. Without them you have no existence at all. So the heroes of these days, heroes I mean the warriors who struggled hard for Sai movement, hailing from villages, We are just hand-to-mouth income. That's all. And they sacrifice everything for the organization. In those days, today, if you are not a Sai devotee, the world will laugh at you. Today, if you say, I don't know Sai Baba, people will think that planet Earth is not the place meant for you. Baba is known everywhere today. Baba is known to everyone today. When I say, I know Baba, I'm a devotee, Baba, that and this, status symbol, dignity, respectability, honor, credibility, accountability, simplicity, humility, they all go in perfect precision, in order, when once you say, I'm a Sai devotee, today. But those years, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, would you believe me, my friends, when I say 40 years ago, when devotees started visiting this place, many people are discouraged to come here. Discouraged. There at Anantapur, the first place, the Anantapur, you know, when you just get down there, those people say, where are you going? Puttaparthi. What sort of fellow you are? Are you mad or what? Go back. That's what they say. They used to make fun of you. They heckle at you. They're at Anantapur. Anantapur. When you come to Dharmavaram, they say, it's not too late to go back. You have become objects of mockery, criticism, heckling by the public in those days. There are some housewives who visited this place without the knowledge of their husbands, telling that they are going to their mother's house because they feel Swami is their mother. That they were the days. And they lived under the trees. Not north one, north two with geysers and sinks. We have sinks in every room and we are sinking spiritually. They lived under the trees, yes. No facility, nothing. And rain god will favor them when the campus is full. Yes. So that you don't need to wash them, that's all. Rain god will make them wet, sun god will make them dry. And even if you want to stay in the hotels outside, I stayed there first time, long back, 70s. In one of the hotels, he is an owner of a sari also, shop, sari shop. I stayed. You stay there, he said. First visit with children. And I stayed there, and really a wonderful accommodation indeed. You can bring down the window and keep it there. You can just remove the door, keep it there. Everything replaceable, collapsible. Air conditioned, because air does not enter. Huh? You have to search for people inside. All things collapsible like that. And then bath and any other thing that you want to attend in the morning time, open university. Open university. And the hot water, you have to pay 25 naya paisa. Are in the old coins, pavala, just for an S. They give you hot water. You have to mix and take bath anywhere. The whole nature is the best teacher, nature. That was the life. And what made them repeat their visits? The kind of faith they had in Swami. We are no match to them, my friends. No match. That was the Himalayan dimension of faith of those devotees of yesteryears. So I wanted to bring to the notice of the general public the names of the devotees I know spread all over Andhra Pradesh, 23 districts, plus many of the districts from Orissa. I toured. Mentioning those names, I wanted to convey what kind of exemplary life they led to inspire us. So with all said and done, the objectives of memories and memoirs is not to blow my trumpet. Enough is enough. Or not to dance to the other tune either. It's only to narrate experiences I have seen personally and to convey the underlying message of Baba in every experience and message. And third, to bring to light those leaders of the organization, villagers, innocents of those years who are forgotten and less cared for today. With that objective I am writing. I do not know how long it would go. But Baba sent another man to translate these Telugu articles into English. They are published in English also, parallelly, so that you can certainly read those memories and memoirs that will be covering these four aspects. And that is done by Mr. Satish, the video man there. He is translating all this into English. And these articles are available in the website saiwisdom.com. I repeat again, the website saiwisdom.com has got all these articles, memories and memoirs, for information. Then coming back to the point I was talking to you, a kind of set of people, like-minded, are required. If you go on speaking of your own personal agenda, suppose you are interested in making money, if you are interested in flats purchased outside, plots purchased outside, if you are interested in the politics inside, if you are interested in spreading the rumors faster than anybody, wind, water or insects, they carry pollen, we carry stories. So we can do that. But left to me, I am not at all interested. Please, if anyone says, it seems there so-and-so is replaced, so-and-so is appointed, I tell them both of them will be displaced tomorrow. What is after all? To be here, we are working at some place or other. Not that for work we are here, no. We are not here for work's sake. We are here for a spiritual ambience, for a spiritual atmosphere to prevail, so that we can think together, so that we can grow together. As Baba often says, the spiritual journey is togetherness. Join together, sing together, exchange your views together, with a common objective of being closer and closer to Bhagavan, with no complex of superiority or inferiority. Therefore, suddenly, intuitively, I got a feeling. What I have been doing every Sunday here is all downloaded and kept in the website, saiwisdom.com. And all the talks there, printouts are made, and as on today, 25 books are published by the divine grace of Bhagavan with your cooperation. With your cooperation. I am grateful to my Sunday satsang group. Please believe me, for lifetime. Had you not been here, I would not have prepared any subject at all. Had you not been here, it would not have been possible to talk and exchange our views. Had you not been here, 500 DVD talks would not have been made as on today. Had you not been there, the website would not have been in existence at all. So Sunday Satsang Group, please believe me, I am eternally grateful. Eternally grateful to each and every one of you, with prayers to Bhagwan to bless you and your families forever and ever, so that our journey towards Baba will be onward and forward for years to come. With the same feeling, I thought, why can't we have another session? Not merely the Sunday, some other extra session. Why? The life is coming to a close. After all, I am not going to live here for another 70 years. No. Who knows? Life need not be a comma, it may be full stop. Anytime. There are so many things to be done. So many thoughts to share, so many things to write on. What all I have written, I am not satisfied. Many more are to be written, many more. Sai is ocean. From that ocean, if you collect glass of water and say, aha, I have taken the whole of ocean, you are not sage Agastya to swallow all water of the oceans. Impossible. So there is so much of work still to be done in the field of writing. And in the field of talking and sharing the views, public talks, more has to be done now than before. Because Baba in his physical form has been impressing everybody, has been close to everybody externally. But now that he is not, external appearance is not there. We have to be closer. We have to be more intimate. We have to be more loving, more affectionate, more of concern, and share with each other, so that Sai group will be very strong. Like iron beam, we should be very strong. We all say that Baba represents unity of religions. Good. Can I link Christ with Baba? No. Can I correlate Islam with Baba? No. Can I say parallels between Buddha teachings and Baba's teachings? No. Can I say anything of Zoroaster and Baba's teachings? No. Can I bring in parallels between Swami and Krishna? No. Rama and Sai? No. What do I know? My dreams, my experiences, how he named my son, how he has cut the first grown hair of my grandchild. Better you be cut totally, I tell you. We are fed up with those stories. We are fed up. How about the concrete spirituality? How about basic, fundamental spiritual awareness for which Baba has come down on earth? All these things around are undeniable, I accept. They are true, nobody can question. But the underlying motive behind all this in Sai action is to bring about this awareness among all of us. What awareness? That I am God. How godly I am, you know me better. How godly people all around, deadly. Not godly, deadly. We speak of human values, what are they? How are they practiced? If we ask for extra spoon of sambar, they lose shanti or peace. If we change our seat in Kulwanda Hall, we'll taste what prema is. Love, love. And where are we? I put these questions to myself. I'm not criticizing anybody. Where am I in the midst of all these contradictions? In the midst of all differences? In the midst of all thoughts and counter thoughts? Where am I? When Swami says, who am I? I am not able to know where I am. Therefore, to discuss the crux, the spiritual content, the spiritual philosophy of Baba, which will remain for ages to come, but not your dream experience, but not your individual experience, is philosophy. There is one devotee from Vietnam who has written this much a book on Buddha, which I donated to one of the schools here. Buddha's life is full of miracles, same as Bhagwan Baba. But do we speak of them? No. We speak of Buddha's teachings today. Christ love today. Prophet Muhammad's feelings of fraternity today. Therefore, to highlight the teaching, basically, fundamentally, Sai philosophy of life, Sai views of divinity, the ways to explore within ourselves, to touch the fringes of the divinity lying within us. I wanted to start another session without disturbing this schedule. We have one every day. I don't want to disturb this. And my participation every Sunday will continue, except on the day when you don't come. Except on this day when they say, we don't want you. Except on the day when I am away from station, that's all. This will continue. But to share some more thoughts, to publish some more books, to reach out a number of viewers, visitors of our website, saiwisdom.com, more. I got about 50,000 or even more that visit the 50,000 that visit the website regularly, to supply more of information, Sai knowledge, Sai information, more and more. We wanted to start another session. Thursday morning at 10:30. Where? You know the Gopuram there? Just opposite Gopuram, there is HDFC Bank. There are two lifts. One lift is giving trouble now. The other lift is functional. So go to the other lift. It will lift you to the sixth floor. There is a penthouse, a huge hall, which will accommodate 150 or 200. And we can have our satsangs every Thursday at 10:30. And those of you who want the actual address can have it from me also at the end of the session. That's all for the day. And we'll commence Thursday sessions from this Thursday onwards, the 2nd February at 10:30, every Thursday. And there the schedule would be, we chant Omkar, three bhajans, meditation exercises, that would be followed by brief satsang, and we'll also have video shows of Swami cassettes, and also some of my talks there, DVDs also will be played, so that we'll be more engaged in Sai thought. Because most of the people, after having Samadhi Darshan, what are we doing? go to the stores straight. How long can we eat? Until lunchtime. Go for darshan, come back. Have some snack. How long? Until dinner time. As Baba jokes quite often, life has become a process of loading and unloading. But how long? Enough is enough. For decades we spent like that. How long? And that too, many, many new people will be coming. New generation will be coming. What is that learned from us? If I call a newcomer here and tell him, 40 years ago I came, he will say, what if? What if? If I tell him, Swami has given me ring, he will say, he has not given me, so what? So you cannot exhibit all the pieces of gifts of grace by Bhagavan Baba anymore. I cannot simply speak about myself anymore. I didn't do it so far. And I will not do it in future also. Unless the context demands. So, these common things were proceeding. I'm sure all are welcome. I pray Bhagavan to bless our new venture, new experiment, the Thursday exercises, spiritual satsang, to make it possible and successful. Thank you very much. I extend this invitation to everybody. Now, in the time left from now on, I'm happy to find a group from Visakhapatnam, Steel City. Would you please get up, please? Welcome, welcome to all of you. Why did I ask them to get up? Please be seated, thank you. The reason is, my friends, they can ask me or they can even correct me if I am wrong. Steel City, there is a steel plant in Visakhapatnam, government managed, and that steel city was running into losses, heavy losses. It was also led to a situation of closure or merger into another steel plant which was doing well in other parts of the country. At that time, Baba gave them interview and said, it will run well, it is running into profits today. Running, making great profits today. What is Baba? Baba's will is as hard as the steel, as certified by steel plant in Visakhapatnam. May God bless you. We are happy to have you. And we are also happy to have here some of the friends from Zone 4 of Sri Satya Sai International Organization. Zone 4 of Satya Sai International Organization comprises Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Thailand and Brunei. They all belong to Zone 4 of Sri Satya Sai International Organization. As I was talking to you yesterday, as I made a remark yesterday, it is very strange, unbelievable to find the magnitude of work going on there in countries like Malaysia, Indonesia, which are ruled by Muslim officials and ministers. The government belongs to Islamic faith. And there in those countries, these people are spreading Sai message, Sai mission, far, far wide. Indonesia, it will be very strange to know, they have Garuda Airlines. Garuda Airlines? Oh, Garuda. We have some names such as Vijaya. Malaysia, Jaya Putra. Putra Jaya. Putra Jaya, Sanskrit words. And then Indonesia, if you go to places like Bali, you have 40 feet Garukman, 40 feet Krishna, 40 feet Arjuna. Muslim countries. Where is Baba? Baba is there where there is no possibility of Baba's name to get in. Where there is no possibility. Where is Baba? Baba is there where there are no devotees at all, and he could make them centers of activity today. That is Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. To my knowledge, my friends, believe me or not, would you accept that there are 108 water tanks built by youth there in Indonesia? 108 water tanks. And I visited those places to which pure drinking water supply is made, far from the madding crowds, forest area. They drink gutter waters. We can't look at that water also. They fall sick. And for which they have to pay money, even that water is not available free. Now, pure drinking water is supplied to those forest areas because 108 water tanks. That is such a sight. That is such a sight. Marvelous. Marvelous. Then if you think of Malaysia again, all top ministers, right from president, vice president, cabinet ministers, they all know Sai organization, what their activity is. They participate in Sai organization activities. Maximum literature for youth is published there in Malaysia. How to draw youth, how to attract youth into Sai organization, we must learn the techniques from Malaysian organization. How youth are inspired by brothers like Jagdishan. How Jagdishan could attract youngsters into Sai fold. He is not an ordinary man. To me, he looks like a spiritual terrorist. A spiritual terrorist. He can brainwash any man with Sai spirit and Sai love. Can we believe that? In Thailand again, the fraternity devotees there in Thailand, how committed they are. It suffered from flood damage. Floods havoc recently. I know many, many people who left their families, who just spent at home for 1 hour or two, rest of the time in those flood-affected areas, supplying water, food, clothes. That is Satsang Sai Baba, that is Satsang. Satsang Sai Baba is not an idol. Satsang Sai Baba is not a temple. Satsang Sai Baba is not a person. Satsang Sai Baba is not an object. Satsang Sai Baba is a vibrant force. Satsang Sai Baba is a divine motivator in everybody to take to service activities. That is Satsang Sai Baba. That I have seen there in Thailand, my own eyes, what work they have been doing. When there were floods at a very high rate, they still wanted me there to speak. With folded hands I said, this is not the occasion for speech making, because they will kill the speaker when they want water and food. I want to leave for some more time. They were so good, so kind, so loving, to have extended their invitation for a second time, which I happened to visit. And Thailand has got that, Bangkok city has got that kind of culture. How the love they have for their monuments, for the temples. And we see whole Ramayana depicted on the walls in the royal palace. And we find Buddha statues huge. reclining Buddha from that end to that end. You cannot see like that unless you have to see like that. Ananta Padmanabha Swami is smaller than that Buddha there. Whoa! His feet, just his feet, comes to my size. So big. Buddha's temples I have seen. Ayayyo! Hats off to their tradition, hats off to their culture. And I had been to one theater where they show the Thai culture. We too have certain films showing our culture, documentaries. Headache number one. We don't see our documents. In those days, now discontinued, in every theater, before they start the film, they will show 5 to 10 minutes film showing about our country. Please believe me, empty hall. People start getting in after the documentary is over. Why? Dragging. Not at all interesting. They have to distribute anacin tablets as prasadam. See, there in Thailand I have seen that theater picture with the whole stage. Arre, how interesting it was for 2 hours or 3 hours. About 300 people must have participated. Dances, music, water flowing. On the stage you feel that. You feel that water, you feel the sunlight, you feel the moonlight, you feel the mountains. Dances, different kinds of dances, different types of gods appearing there. Wonderful music. You do not know how 3 hours are over. You do not know the skill and technique. As enjoying every second, but crying within. Why? Baba, if we have such skilled people in this land, if we have such committed people in this land, if we have such scientists, technologists, funds, time to do it, well, there is no other country in this world other than India that has much to show to the whole world, that has much to show to the whole world. We have got so many things here. Only thing is, we take it casual, usual, routine matter. Supposing, see, you talk to anybody who settled here, if you go and tell them, Swami did this to me, no reaction on the face. Sir, Swami gave job to my son. Oh. As in chemistry, colorless, odorless, tasteless gas. Why? Because the fellows take it in a matter of routine. But whereas to a newcomer, to devotees, is that so? That is fine. They go on shedding their tears, listening to your experience. That is a sign of a devotee. But we seniors, we cry because we have experience. These tears are different. These tears are born out of jealousy. Those tears are out of love and devotion. These tears are out of competition. Those tears are out of sharing and caring. So we take things for granted. Maybe, I don't know. Watching all that Thailand view there, I felt, is it national curse that we don't care for our rich cultural heritage? Every village has got a monument here. You know that. You know that. Ajanta, Ellora, caves and all. Every temple with thousands of years of history. All right. Let us take it as things are. Therefore, my friends, the Thailand I liked very much. And Thailand has got Sai school there. And Sai school is a model school. Sai school is a center of learning. spreading Sai philosophy of education, training teachers from all over the world for the past several years. That is Thailand, the Sai land. Now let me have this honor of showing them to you. Very few are here. I request devotees from zone 4 to stand so that our brothers and sisters would see them. Please, please, please kindly. Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Thailand, Brunei. God bless you, sir. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you very much. Somehow, with this pleasant note, with a word of prayer to Bhagavan to bless all our brothers and sisters, to encourage all of us as we go forward along the Sai path. With a double role, we have two roles to play now. One, not to lose faith under any circumstance, come what may. Number two, expansion of Sai family. Invite new people, new blood into Sai organization. Sai mission, Sai message. Let them be two eyes, two ears, two lungs to everybody. My prayer is this to all those seniors of my age. Let us meet as many people as possible. Let us encourage people as many as possible. Let us see that they are introduced into Sai organization in every way, such that we will be very strong, so as to make our Lord, avatar of our age, feel happy, continue to shower His munificent grace and blessings for years, years to come. Sai Ram, Sai Ram. Oh, Asato Ma Sagamaya Tamaso Ma Yodirgamaya Mrutyorma Amrutangamaya. Om Samasta Loka Sukhino, Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu, Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti Shanti. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satchai Baba Ji Ki. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satchai Baba Ji Ki. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satchai Baba Ji Ki. God bless you. Thank you.